guys, this is Vineet Pandey, and many of you are surprised. Yes, today I'm playing guitar. Well, why I'm playing a guitar in this video is because I just wanted to tell you that music is very important in our lives. Guys, I'm going to tell you something very important about the music, its role in literature, and my today's special topic is the role of music in Shakespeare. Once Shakespeare said, "If music be the food of love, play on." So the line I'm talking about is from Twelfth Night, where the Duke is in love. Duke Orsino is deeply in love with the Lady Olivia and feels that the music is going to give him some kind of relaxation. So guys, many of you are preparing for NET exams, UGC NET, JRF, SET exams, or MPhil PhD entrance. But how many of you are after knowledge? I, Vineet Pandey, is going to be the first person in India to make a live YouTube video dealing with role of music in Shakespeare. Guys, do you know that Twelfth Night and Tempest have maximum references to music? Or do you know that there was a study done by University of Hull, H-U-L-L, that there are 2,000 different references to music, musical instruments, or some, you know, emotional relation with music? Yes, guys, here we have a lot of references that what kind of musical drums, trumpets, flutes were used by Shakespeare, and who are the characters who have sung songs, or do we have the direct references? Well, friends, in Elizabethan, it was quite prominent that people they would use have some, you know, references from the music. But the very first question that comes is that which is the first play to have music in its content? Friends, it's Gorboduc, a tragedy which is also has a subtitle, The Ferrex and Porrex. Gorboduc is the first play in Tudor dynasty in Elizabethans to have music. Guys, these people were inspired by the Senecan models of tragedy, where the music was introduced to enhance the pleasure, the pain and the sufferings. If you relate the music to Aristotle's concept called catharsis, he simply says that catharsis sometimes helps you to feel those emotions, to be purgated. In fact, the six essential parts, they also have the music as most important part. Friends, what Shakespeare has done to music is that in his comedies he has used lute, while in tragedies he has used trumpet, bandora, dufin and drums. Remember this thing, friends, that bandora and dufin, they were introduced in 1562. Earlier it was not famous, not prominent. Moreover, Shakespeare has used a lot of other kind of musical instruments like the bell viol and cittern. Cittern is the modern guitar. How these characters were using music in their different references. So the very most important, the most important point here we have is that in Shakespeare, the the important characters, they do not sing any songs directly. Either they are in the disguise, like we taking the reference from As You Like It, or they are mentally troubled, like we take the example from Ophelia, when she becomes mad seeing the insanity of Hamlet. Moreover, there are comedies, they have more songs than tragedies. Like if we talk about the most important songs, and I'm going to give you the references, the most important one is the Song of Ariel in Tempest. Then the famous song, What Dreadful Doleful Voice Is This, it is still famous in 21st century, and again Under the Greenwood Tree, Blow Blow the Winter Wind, and there are few more romantic songs involved in various plays. Moreover, remember friends, when Shakespeare performed those plays for the court people in front of Elizabeth and others, they would always have drummers with them to perform the tragic scenes, war scenes, and he always had special people to play the violin and the flute for Elizabeth, especially in the love scenes. But the plays which were performed for the theaters, the drum, the direct dramas, there they had, less people to play these things. They mostly used trumpet to have a better sound. In certain cases, Shakespeare has also used this music of conch shell to let people know. Guys, remember this thing, that most of the Shakespearean plays, they always have some, supernatural elements. We talk about the Macbeth has some supernatural elements. Then we also talk about Midsummer's Night Dream. So whenever there is some supernatural scene is going on, Shakespeare always has the background of the violin. This is the most important thing. Friends, I'm going to talk that these things are very much important, and only someone who has, plans to go for JRF, who wants to top it, he is supposed to read this. If you do not have any passion to go in the depth of knowledge, you can avoid the video. But remember, Vineet Pandey's this effort is one of the unique efforts in India to talk about the role of music in Shakespeare. So please share and subscribe. Thank you so much.